Hi guys, hallo Leute, welcome back to German with Jenny. In this video, I want to introduce the genitive case to you. And I will start by explaining how to use the genitive case with definite articles, so der, die, and das. This is a rather complex topic, so I would suggest you take out your notebooks and take some careful notes today. There is a link below this video that will take you directly to the exercises. So once you've watched this video, make sure to do the exercises. You can also follow me on germanwithjenny.com and be notified whenever I publish new exercises. Let's get started. The most important thing that you need to know is that the genitive shows possession. In English, it's shown by the word of or by adding an apostrophe to show possession. Let's take a look at some examples. In English, you would say the woman's handbag or the handbag of the woman. And in German, you say die Handtasche der Frau. Die Handtasche der Frau. In colloquial speech, most of the time you will hear die Handtasche von der Frau. But it's very important that when you write a text, especially in a formal exam, it's very important that you use the genitive. I would advise that you learn both forms. So in spoken language, it's much more natural to use die Handtasche von der Frau. But in written language, I would suggest that you write die Handtasche der Frau. It sounds much better, it's grammatically correct, and it's the way that you should write a text. Next example, the girl's doll, or the doll of the girl. In German, die Puppe des Mädchens, die Puppe des Mädchens, or in colloquial speech, die Puppe von dem Mädchen. Next example, the father's suit, or the suit of the father. In German, der Anzug des Vaters, der Anzug des Vaters, or colloquially, der Anzug von dem Vater. Next example, the children's clothes, or the clothes of the children. In German, die Anziehsachen der Kinder, die Anziehsachen der Kinder, or colloquially, die Anziehsachen von den Kindern. Many of you might ask yourselves, Anziehsachen, I've never heard of that before. This is also actually very colloquial. If you want to say this in a more formal way, you would say die Kleidung der Kinder. Another colloquial way of saying it would be die Klamotten der Kinder. Now let's take a look at how the genitive is formed. And I want to start by introducing definite articles to you. You already know the definite articles in the nominative case. Let's take a look at these examples. Der Vater, the father. Die Frau, the woman. Das Auto, the car. Die Kinder, the children. The genitive forms would be des Vaters, which means of the father. Der Frau, which means of the woman. Des Autos, which means of the car. And der Kinder, which means of the children. So you can see that der changes to des in the masculine form, die changes to der in the feminine form, das changes to des in the neutral form, and die changes to der in the plural form. But you can also see two other changes. You can see that we add an s in the masculine form at the end of the noun, and we do the same in the neutral form. So we add an s at the end of the noun. Adding an S at the end of the noun happens when there's more than one syllable. Let's take a look at some more examples. Der Fernseher becomes des Fernsehers. Die Lampe becomes der Lampe. Das Badezimmer becomes des Badezimmers. And die Häuser becomes der Häuser. More examples. Der Bildschirm, nominative. Des Bildschirms, genitive. Die Straße, nominative. Der Straße, genitive. Das Fenster, nominative. Des Fensters, genitive. Die Familien, nominative. Der Familien, genitive. When the rules of N declination apply, we have to add an N or an EN. This means that der Junge becomes des Jungen in the genitive case. You can see that the plural, doesn't change except for the article, so die Architekten becomes der Architekten. More examples. Der Mensch, nominative, des Menschen, genitive. Die Kunden, nominative, der Kunden, genitive. In many cases, you add an es at the end of the noun if the noun only has one syllable. Such as in these examples. Der Baum, nominative, des Baumes, genitive. Das Land, nominative, des Landes, genitive. More examples. Der Weg, nominative, des Weges, genitive. Das Kind, nominative, des Kindes, genitive. Nouns ending in sch and st often add es. Der Tisch becomes des Tisches. Das Fest becomes des Festes. Nouns ending in s, double s, sz, z, tz, and chs add an es. Der Fluss becomes des Flusses. Das Haus becomes des Hauses. Der Witz becomes des Witzes. Das Glas becomes des Glases. Der Fuchs becomes des Fuchses. Das Schloss becomes des Schlosses. Nouns ending in nis add ses at the end. Das Ergebnis becomes des Ergebnisses. Das Verhältnis becomes des Verhältnisses. When you use first names, you just add an S to the first name to show possession. Such as in these examples, Annas Buch, Anna's book, or Karls Frau, Karl's wife. If the name already ends in S or Z, an apostrophe is added. Johannes Buch, Heinz Hut. Geographical names without articles also add an S. Die Hauptstadt Deutschlands ist Berlin. The capital of Germany is Berlin. Frankreichs Küsten sind wunderschön. The coasts of France are beautiful. Wir gingen durch die Innenstadt Londons. We walked through the downtown area of London. However, if the geographical name has an article, you cannot just add an S. Such as in this example, das Wasser der Donau fließt durch den Naturpark Obere Donau. The water of the Danube flows through the natural park Obere Donau. So Donau has a feminine article, die Donau. So we have to transform it into der Donau in the genitive case. Jetzt seid ihr dran. Testet euer Wissen. Now it's your turn. Test your knowledge. I will give you the nominative forms of these nouns and then you have to come up with the genitive forms. Der Hund, the dog. Die Katze, the cat. Das Pferd, the horse. Die Tiere, the animals. And I will give you a couple of seconds to think about it. These are the genitive forms. Des Hundes, of the dog. Der Katze, of the cat. Des Pferdes, of the horse. Der Tiere, of the animals. Und weiter geht's. Der Zug, the train. Die Tochter, the daughter. Das Telefon, the phone. Die Schulen, the schools. Once again, I'll give you a couple of seconds to think about it. The genitive forms are des Zuges, of the train, der Tochter, of the daughter, des Telefons, of the phone, der Schulen, of the schools. Weiter geht's. Der Fuß, the foot, die Erdnuss, the peanut, das Problem, the problem, die Dateien, the files. The genitive forms are des Fußes, of the foot, der Erdnuss, of the peanut, des Problems, of the problem, der Dateien, of the files. In the following examples, you're going to have to correct the mistakes. So what I did is I always used the nominative case where I should have used the genitive case. Let's take a look at the first sentence. Ich gehe mit dem Hund der Nachbar spazieren. How would you say this correctly? In actual fact, there are two correct answers. You could say, ich gehe mit dem Hund des Nachbarn spazieren, which means I am walking the neighbor's dog, and this would just be one neighbor. Or you could say, ich gehe mit dem Hund der Nachbarn spazieren. So I'm walking the dog of more than one neighbor. So it might be a couple's dog, and those are two people, so we would say der Nachbarn. Next one. Er ist mit dem Motorrad der Mann weggefahren. So he drove away with the man's motorbike. How would you say this correctly? The correct sentence would be, er ist mit dem Motorrad des Mannes weggefahren. Maria fährt am Montag mit dem Auto die Mutter zur Arbeit. So Maria is going to work on Monday with the mother's car. How would you say this correctly in German? The correct sentence would be, Maria fährt am Montag mit dem Auto der Mutter zur Arbeit. Next example. Sophia spielt mit dem Spielzeugauto der Bruder. So we're trying to say, Sophia is playing with the brother's toy car. How would you say this correctly in German? The correct answer would be, Sophia spielt mit dem Spielzeugauto des Bruders. Die Architekten entwerfen den Grundriss, das Gebäude. So the architects are designing the layout of the building. How would you say this correctly in German? The correct sentence would be, die Architekten entwerfen den Grundriss des Gebäudes. Die Besucher das Schloss kaufen eine Eintrittskarte. So the visitors of the castle are buying a ticket, or literally an entrance ticket. How would you say this correctly in German? The correct sentence is, die Besucher des Schlosses kaufen eine Eintrittskarte. Last example. Der Bodensee, der Chiemsee, der Edersee und der Müggelsee gehören zu den schönsten Seen Deutschlands. How would you say this correctly? The correct sentence would be, der Bodensee, der Chiemsee, der Edersee und der Müggelsee gehören zu den schönsten Seen Deutschlands. Alright, I hope that wasn't too complicated. There's a link below this video that will take you directly to the exercises so you can practice everything that we learned today. If you like my videos and you want to support me, you can do that on patreon.com/germanwithjenny, where you can make a monthly contribution. Just $1 a month is already a huge help.